Eye care emergencies can be a very scary thing to deal with. Whether you got scratched or poked in the eye, maybe a foreign body or chemical splash to the eye, these sort of emergencies can cause severe pain, redness, and even lead to vision loss and even blindness for some people. And I can tell you from seeing these sort of cases every single week in the eye clinic, people often make critical mistakes early on that if they just would have done things a little differently, they could have avoided such tragic problems and would have helped avoid having such bad complications and would have healed their eye better. So in this video, I'm going to share some eye care emergency tips and some eye care first aid prep that'll help you be more prepared when emergency strikes so that you can have better outcomes. So smash that like button and let's take a look. Hey, what's up everyone? This is Dr. Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, so you can keep seeing your best today and for tomorrow. So if you're new here to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button down below so that you don't miss any of my future videos. And to start us off, I think the most common thing that I see in the eye clinic is probably people coming in with foreign bodies or some sort of chemical exposure to the eye. And when we say foreign bodies, I mean any sort of foreign object that could have gotten into the eye. Most commonly, we'll see people with chunks of metal from grinding out in the workshop or in a garage somewhere and not wearing proper safety eye protection. Or maybe they were cutting wood or splitting wood or something like that and a sliver came up and got them. I've seen a lot of different things get in the eye. I've even seen like popcorn kernels and things like that. If a chemical or a foreign body ever gets into your eye, the first thing that most people will do just out of instinct is they go up to rub their eye. And do not do that. Try your best to urge yourself to not, have that little voice in the back of your head, to not rub your eye. Rubbing the eye is just gonna either make things worse by digging the foreign body deeper into the eye, or it's just gonna kind of expose that chemical again deeper into the tissue. You don't wanna do that. So again, I say, do not rub the eyes. The next big thing is you need to rinse your eye. If you were a contact lens wearer, especially again with chemicals or anything like that, make sure you quick wash your hands and remove those contacts immediately. And then you need to flush your eyes. Now there are several ways to flush the eyes. If you are at work or a place of business that has an eye wash station that is perfect, to go use that. If you don't have that available, like I don't have that here in my house, instead I go up to either the bathroom or kitchen sink and I turn my eyes under the faucet and I turn on warm water. Don't turn on hot water or freezing cold water, just something kind of lukewarm. It's gonna be more comforting, but you wanna flush that eye out for at least about 15 minutes. And this can be somewhat challenging, especially when your eye is in pain, but you wanna make sure you're blinking frequently and that you're able to kind of hold that eye open a bit so that the water flushes right in and then flushes out. Again, you want to rinse whatever chemicals or foreign object might have gotten into the eye. You want to try your best to get that out of the eye. If you happen to be a parent with a young child who got something into their eye, this might be pretty tough because the kids are often pretty hysterical. They want to get their things out of their eyes. So they may be trying to either rub their eyes really hard or you need to calm them down, but you just need to rest assure them that things are going to be okay and that yes, you do need to rinse whatever's in the eye out of it and it's going to make it feel better. Now, after rinsing the eye, whether you think you got everything out of there or not, I do think it is best to call a local eye care professional in your area right away to see if they can get you to be seen. In general, for these sort of emergencies, you have a foreign body or chemical exposure, it's usually not best to go straight to the emergency room because many times the emergency rooms don't have all the technical equipment that we have in the eye clinic to address these issues. Usually the doctors and medical staff in the emergency room are amazing at fixing broken bones. If you've seriously injured yourself or you're having a heart attack, then definitely go to the ER, but for most cases, eyes, they kind of shy away from really touching those too much. They just don't have the equipment to really see what's going on. So if you do live in an area that has a dedicated eye care professional, whether an ophthalmologist or optometrist, they can usually address your needs a little bit better with more finesse to reduce your chances of having complications. And from there, if your eye doctor can't address the issues or they have something out of their hands, then they will direct you over to the emergency room. Otherwise, 9 times out of 10, the doctors at the emergency room always end up referring you over to us anyway. But again, of course, if you don't have an eye doctor in your area, then definitely go ahead and proceed, call the emergency room, see if you can get seen. Even if you got a foreign body in the eye and you think you rinsed it out, I still think it's a good idea to be seen, get things checked out so they can be sure that everything did get out of the eye. It's amazing how many times I'll find rust particles and different little beads of stuff under the eyelids. What often happens is something will get stuck under the eyelid, and every time you blink, that little piece of whatever is going up and down and scratching your eye over and over again. And let's just say in the case of a chemical exposure, $10 or something, splash it up into your eye. See if you can bring the canister or whatever the chemical came in and bring that with you going into the eye care professional, because they'll want to see what exactly that chemical is, if it's something that they need to neutralize further, or there's better understanding of how those chemicals react on the eye. Because depending on the chemical and the pH, whether it's really acidic or basic, that will change a little bit of what your doctor is going to understand how that's going to affect the eye. And just a fun fact, although most people think an acid exposure to the eye would be pretty bad, in fact, just on the opposite end of the spectrum, something very basic, such as sodium hydroxide that's used in soap making, for example, is usually way, way worse for the eyes. But again, the big things are don't rub the eyes, rinse the eyes super well, and call your eye doctor right away. One handy thing I want to mention in case you have an emergency kit or just want to keep it in your medicine cabinet is something such as eyewash. This is just an eye relief eyewash that you can buy generically over the pharmacy or through online. This one is from Bausch & Lomb. Works pretty simple. It's just an eyewash solution that you can use to clean out the eye in case, again, something gets in there or splashes in there. And overall, it works pretty easily. You can either tilt your head back and squirt it directly into the eye, or it has a little eye cup that you can fill with water, and then it's just a matter of holding that to the eyelid and blinking multiple times as it rinses out the eye. The one big thing about any eye wash I would mention, even though it's like 99% sterile water, it does have a preservative in it called benzyl clonium chloride, or BAK. And in the eye care community, we know this as a very good preservative for eye drops. However, BAK can really hurt or irritate the eyes for a lot of people. And so you never want to use this with contact lenses. If you try to use it as a contact lens disinfecting solution or store your contacts in it, do not do that. It's going to burn your eyes. Again, don't do that. It's only for eyewash only. What I always thought was funny is that the little plastic cup that it has, I actually have an old glass little eye cup like this that my grandparents left me when I graduated school. I don't really see these glass ones made anymore, but it's kind of a cool little hand-me-down. It kind of reminds me of a little Sunday scoop sort of thing if I had a tiny little spoon. Now let's answer a quick question live from this week's comments. We have Alex Wexhov who asks, I am 17 and have many floaters, but in one eye I have a big floater, like a big curtain. Is this normal? Well, Alex, honestly, when it comes to any sort of new floaters in your vision, especially big ones, you definitely want to get that checked out. In fact, if you're starting to see a big curtain in your vision, whether it be a blurry curtain or if it's a black curtain coming down from the ceiling or maybe rising up from the floor, that could potentially be something more serious, such as retinal tear or detachment, and you definitely want to get that checked out as soon as you can. So if you haven't seen a doctor to have that checked out, I encourage you, call your local eye doctor and get seen. Otherwise, Alex, thanks again for the question. I hope things turn out. If you or anybody else have questions, comments about eye care, drop them in the comments section. I hope to feature yours in my next upcoming video. Next on today's list is getting scratches, pokes, or abrasions to the surface of the eye. And these can come from little babies poking their moms in their eye with their finger to a tree branch coming back, smacking someone in the eye. There's a lot of things that can scratch the eyes. And usually in these cases, you're gonna end up with a painful red eye that hurts every single time you blink. And I always say if the eye is painful, if it's red, or if your vision changes at all, you need to again call your eye doctor and get seen. And again, if the thing that hit in the eye was perhaps dirty, like dirty fingers or something like that, it's best again to rinse the eyes out, and then call the eye doctor. If the eye just feels a little bit irritated, but you're not having redness or pain or any of the kind of vision changes, then oftentimes just making sure the eye gets lubricated with some sort of an eye drop is definitely appropriate. Oftentimes when patients come in, we'll give them samples of different eye drops, usually something either kind of runnier or more liquid that is better throughout the day because it doesn't distort your vision. But oftentimes you'll find something a little bit thicker, such as a gel drop, will last a little bit longer on the eye and make it more comfortable. However, because the gel is a little bit thicker and more viscous, it may blur your vision. A big thing about using eye drops, if you're heading into the eye clinic, try to avoid any eye drops that say get the red out. Typically, Visine is one that's very well known. Most people use that to get the red out of their eyes. Try to avoid anything that's getting the red out because that will artificially turn the eye more whitish and make it look healthier than if it was truly just red, and your eye doctor may not appropriately diagnose or treat that eye because it's been artificially blanched to the blood vessels. So if in general, if you're using an eye drop at all, especially before going in to see the eye doctor, it's best to just use a neutral artificial tear that doesn't have those extra chemicals in it. If you are someone who's using eye drops multiple times throughout the day, I'm talking more than 4 or 5 drops throughout the day, it is best to reach for a non-preserved or preservative-free eye drop. Almost every single brand has these different type of drops. They come in these little individual vials, these little dropperettes. But these type of drops are usually best just because then you don't have all these extra chemical preservatives going into the eye. Now the next quick tip I wanted to share has to do with eye allergies. A lot of people will go out for a hike or they'll go travel someplace new and suddenly they're having this allergic response. Their eyes are getting red and puffy and they want to scratch at them all the time. That's oftentimes allergy symptoms. And that's just a histamine response by your body to any sort of allergen in the air, such as pollen, grass, ragweed, those sort of things. Now, when it comes to dealing with eye allergies, I have a lot of other tips I've recommended in other videos. One of the big, quick, easy things I think you can have on hand in your emergency kit is something like Pataday. Pataday used to be a prescription-only eye drop for allergies that only eye doctors could prescribe here in the United States. But this medication has since kind of lost its patent, and now it's available over-the-counter. It only costs about $20 or so. It comes in both a one-time-a-day dosing that's more for itchiness, kind of the puffiness of the eye, but it does also comes in a twice-a-day dosing, which is good for allergies, but also helps with a little bit of the redness too. If you don't have access to Pataday right away with you, and you do have just some sort of generic artificial tear, definitely use that. That'll rinse out pollen out of the eye, or grab a cold washcloth or something cool that you can hold to your eyelid, because that'll cool down the swelling. If you do want to dive more deep into dealing with allergies or puffy eyes, I do have a couple of those videos, and you can check those out either by clicking the link up here to the side, or I'll include a link to the full videos down in the description below. In addition, if you're someone who just loves being ultra prepared for any sort of emergency, I have a friend, Denise Jordan, who recently did kind of a review or prepping of her first aid kit, and I encourage you to go check that out if you want to learn a little bit more, and I'll include that video link in the video description below, again, so you can check it out. Otherwise, the last little bonus tip that I would often keep in our first aid kit or definitely in our medicine cabinet is something like hypochlorous acid. If you've never heard of hypochlorous acid, I have done another video on it, but hypochlorous acid, in short, is a disinfectant. It is safer than using something like bleach, where bleach can be pretty irritating to the skin. Hypochlorous acid is like a brother to it. However, it's much safer, doesn't burn your skin, and it can be used for multiple different uses. In fact, it was first invented to help with healing diabetic foot ulcers. But hypochlorous acid, this is just one that my friends over at the Eye Love Company make. This one is the Lid and Lash Cleanser. They specifically make it for cleaning the eyelids, which helps with blepharitis, the buildup of bacteria and skin oils around the eyelashes. But it's also really good for helping with dry eyes. And if you happen to be somebody with like irritants or stuff around the eyes, it's just good for cleaning the eyelids. But I always find it really helpful for just cleaning around the eyes, or if you have any sort of little scrapes, or maybe you rub the eye a little bit with your finger and you're like, oh, what did I just put on my eyelid? This will help clean off any sort of nasty germs or anything that's like that. And again, it's gentle enough, it's not gonna dry out or hurt your skin. Otherwise, I really hope you found this video helpful, that next time if you are in one of those emergencies, whether it's you, a friend, or a family member, you can act fast, make sure you can help them, tell them not to rub the eyes, rinse out the eyes if they need to, and then call the eye doctor right away. If you want to check out anything like the eyewash or hydrate solution or any of the eye drops that I mentioned in this video, you can always check out the links in the video description below so you can find them easily. Again, this is Dr. Joseph Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. Thanks so much for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.